How's it going, everyone? I'm ErrorNick, and welcome back to Neverending Nightmares. In this part, I am just going to play through until I am completely done with the game. I have two endings to go, and no matter how long this part is, I'm just going to play through, whether it be, you know, 20 minutes, half hour, an hour. I'm just going to play through the rest of the game. We seem to be back. I just went through like the dark, and I was being chased by, you know, my sister or wife, or it's really confusing at this point. And now I'm back in like the house, and it seems like the beginning of the game again, almost, when I was avoiding the babies. That's what it seems to be setting up to. I think the last section was definitely up there for one of my favorite sections of the game so far, though. Just because it was so innovative, it was... Wake up, Thomas. I'm interested, though, to, like, see the other endings and kind of wonder, like, okay, this is different. Wonder which one's going to be my favorite ending. Wonder what the other two endings are going to be like. Knowing this game, there's no telling. Oh, she's hanging there. Hello. Hello. Just keep walking by the bodies. Okay, that tree has hands. Hand tree. They're hanging. I'm probably going to, like, the graves again or something. Or no, it looks like I'm going into a cave. Well, they have a secret dungeon out back that we didn't know of. It comes to light in the final chapter of the game. Oh, that was cool. I like that transition. That was really cool. I was kind of getting excited, though, for, like, a seat. Okay. I was getting excited, though, for a, for a whole, like, underground area, though. Like, you know, organs and stuff. That would have been neat. Had it laid out all in my head. Who's that? Okay, nothing in that room. Just looked like a storage room. I'm not really expecting this to take an hour, though. I know I said it, you know, I'll play all the way through no matter how long's left, but I expect that I already got through one of the three areas I needed to get through. Oh, that's a lot of glass. Do I have to walk over all that? Oh. The thought of doing that just hurts so bad. I mean, it's been one thing when I've, like, stepped over the broken glass, like, once, just to be like, okay, I know it's there, but I step over it, and... Yep, there's the guy hanging again. They've had incredible attention to detail, though. The detail in this game is phenomenal. Alright, so that's a bed. So I'm thinking whenever I walk into a room and just see a bed, I'm thinking that if I died, then I just return to the last bed that I saw. So I think beds are just kind of like checkpoints. Who's breathing? Oh, hey. Well, they're back. You don't see me? Alright. Bye-bye. Aw, I was kind of hoping for new enemies. you show ahead of me, please? I don't want to see, like... Yeah, there we go. Alright, at least I made it to the stairs. Yeah, there's always something you're working towards, though, in this game. It seems like, so, like, in each part, it's, you're always working to go down. I don't know if that's, like, a metaphor for, like, the downward spiral into madness. Like, you're always working... Yeah, there's graves inside now. Things get more... creepy and crazy. Karen Marie Gillenbach, Ian Craig, Cindy U, Linwood Smith, Mary Lynn, Edgar D. Taylor. Oh! She's waving. Hi. Johnny Rivers. I was reading, so that caught me even more by surprise. Sarah Northway. Gabriel Black. That one didn't give me as bad. I was kind of expecting. She's waving again, though. Hi. Adam Sessler. Hey. Wasn't he, X-Play. Yeah. Kevin A. Smith. Oh, are these all, like, kind of, like, famous people? Like, I mean, I know. Hi. That's really interrupting. You're an interrupting person, you know that? Just lay there and think about that. I just don't know if, like, maybe all those people are, like, involved in video games. Like, just because a lot of times they put, like, those little Easter eggs and stuff, maybe those are all, like, little Easter eggs. Like, each name is an Easter egg. Like, someone, like, some of the girls might be, like, the wives of, like, different developers and stuff. That's all I was thinking. It's bloody and that music is playing. Sounds like reverse music. Okay. I'm saying hi a lot. I'm intrigued by all the people I'm meeting. You meet interesting people in this game. That's the thing. You get to meet and converse with some very interesting individuals. It's like speed dating. It's not very long once they get a hold of you. You have a fine glass of scotch there. Scotch on the rocks. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the way I'm supposed to go, but I like exploring, so I'm gonna explore. Alright, there's no point in exploring. Screw exploring. Exploring is pointless. Yeah, the paintings are getting, like, more and more depraved and stuff. Every single painting is pretty disturbing now. She's not even holding an axe. That's just a big, like, cleaver thing. I should have noticed that, like, earlier, but damn. Hello. Hello. Come on. Disappear. Did she disappear? Oh, she disappeared now. Okay, there we go. I was wondering, like, what the hell? She normally just disappeared after a second. Oh, they're stoning this woman. Or no, maybe she's asking for the rocks. Give me back my rocks! They took her rocks and she wants them back. Damn, I have a fucked up mind just thinking about that stuff. Like, that was actually, like, a problem back in the day. I'm sure there's probably still places in the world that end up stoning people. Oh, I stepped on glass. Okay. Okay, what seems to be happening to me, like... What I'm thinking is this is a collaboration of every single area I've encountered in the game thus far, is what I think is happening. So it's like everything is just all jumbled up, and this is the point of, like, madness, kind of. He's reaching that peak moment that everything is a lie. Where, yeah, everything is kind of like a lie. He can't. He's not thinking straight at all. It's just everything is completely jumbled, and he's just spiraling into madness. I'm thinking that this ending might have something to do back with the insane asylum, because that's where I was injected. Oh, baby. Hello. Wait, I can't make it down the stairs, so I have to grab for you. I'm thinking I'm gonna end up back here, and this is gonna maybe be the ending where I'm gonna be in the padded cell. Why not? Goes back to the building. I have no clue. I'm just speculating. I think if I had to guess about the other two endings, so the first ending was based off of suicidal thoughts, where he was suicidal because of his depression. Which is never a good thing. You should never get to that point. And if you do, there's people there to help. I mean, I'd be willing to help any, like, random person that would come up to me and, you know, say, like, they need help. That's partly just me. Like, I'd always be willing to help a person in need. No matter who they are, no matter how long I've known them, it's just... important to be a good person to me. Bear. But anyways, I was thinking, I kind of already forgot where I was. I was thinking about the different endings. So I'm thinking one's gonna be, you know, that first one's based off of depression leading into suicidal thoughts. I'm thinking one ending might be so creepy. Thinking one's gonna be based off like acceptance, and he won't be crazy anymore. She's eating her own intestines is what's going on there. So I think there's gonna be like a true ending where it's just gonna be like acceptance of like creepy puppet hands coming up. Don't let me step on the tentacles. I think there's gonna be a true ending based on acceptance, where he'll come out of the nightmare and... Oh! I was expecting a little bit. I think there's gonna be something that grabbed me. Acceptance based on the nightmares, he'll accept the nightmares and that they're, you know... And then there's gonna be another ending that's gonna be, insanity. Where you're just in an insane asylum and they're gonna say like no treatments are effective or something. Aww, I don't like any of this. Alright. I don't like anything that's going on here. Bearhead. I don't know where I'm at. I mean, it's kind of like the house, but at the same time, it's not quite. It's got like a lot of hunting features. Like, it seems almost like a hunting cabin. And I'm thinking if I was like stemming off the acceptance pattern, maybe I'd like find some trauma or something. And you find the root of all his nightmares. Oh, she's hanging there. Oh, damn. Oh. Jesus. This area just keeps going and going, though. There's a lot. They got the build up right. they got me thinking. I'm thinking, like, you know, 100 miles a minute right now, just like, what's going on? Why my character just keeps descending? What did these metaphors mean? Like, I really hope that the developer is kind of just like exaggerating their experiences with depression a little bit, because this would be like really upsetting. I'm in like an eye, or the womb.
Dear Thomas, I'm leaving you. I'm sorry. You can't talk me out of it. I still love you, but I just can't be with you anymore. Losing our daughter was hard on me too, yet I'm trying to move on. Your life didn't end, so why can't you live it? I hope you can get past this tragedy eventually, I really do. I guess this is goodbye. Love, Gabrielle.
Okay, well, that was way different than I was guessing. I'm happy I made the guesses, that it can just be like, oh, look at me, I'm so stupid for guessing wrong. But I really, like, I was making an attempt to guess. I was thinking that that was what it was going to be like. So that one was, like, way different, where that was continuing on the whole, like, that's his wife, and then the younger looking one is actually his daughter. So there was what you end up thinking is the adult version of the sister, and the younger version of the sister ends up being that one is the wife and one is the daughter, and the daughter died in an accident. Alright. Yep. Okay, so somehow you can go back from, I don't know if you can actually see my mouse, but you can go back from one of the nightmares there and actually go into the original one. Okay, so I have one more ending that I'm going to be playing in this part, and I'll cut until I reach the decision point again, which is in the cemetery where you go a different path. Okay, so this is actually where the decision is supposed to be made, where you're supposed to go through the cemetery, and then on the other side of the cemetery, there's a path north and there's a path south. I took the path north initially, but this time I'm supposed to take the south path, and I should get a different outcome at the end of this. Maybe it's another second. Maybe I started a little too early, but that's okay. It's a little bit better, because, I mean, the last time I was doing a different decision, it was the last video, and it was just like, boom, all of a sudden, like, it was wildly different. Did I make a mistake, maybe? Oh, nope, that's different. Okay. I thought I made a mistake, but clearly it's like, it was the same thing. It was just when I woke up, I was still a kid and it was different. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Things don't grab me under the bed. Oh, I'm in the insane asylum as a kid now. How can he even look that high? Did he get on his tippy toes? Did he use Hoist Mr. Rabbit up? That rabbit's cool though. Alright, this should be this is the last area of the game. After this, I get all three endings and I can kinda then piece together what I make of the entire game. Interesting enough though. One theme that I've kinda noticed so far with the different areas though is there seems to be, like, whichever ending I've had so far, so for the other two endings it was not the endings but the end areas, there's a moment where you're just in complete darkness. I'm thinking that's gonna be a those blind guys again. I think that's what I'm hearing. So I have to avoid those guys in this area. Doctor's office. Okay. This seems to be like... This area has appeared several times. And you go in... Here's the storage room. Yeah, there's really not any point to there. I always go in that door, even though there's nothing in there. It's fine. Oh, back in the house. Yeah, this one, I was expecting to be a little different. It's still kind of the same thing. It's all just jumbled ideas. I wonder if that monster under the bed thing is going to come back, though. Because it did, like, it grabbed him and pulled him under the bed. So I'm wondering if I should be watching shadows to be, like, grabbing me. Hello. I wasn't very nervous walking up to that one. I think I've seen enough messed up stuff. Just playing through the rest of this, that it kind of doesn't affect me anymore. You don't affect me anymore, game. That's usually when they get me. It seems to always happen. It's usually like the moment I'm talking about, like, the game not being very creepy anymore. For some reason, that doll that I'm standing in front of right now, this one right here, that my guy's kind of like staring at, is the creepiest doll I've seen so far. It's blanket. Alright. Insomnus Veritas. I am sensing a little bit of a religious overtone in this game, though, too. Because of the scripture and the, and some of the imagery like that, like the Christian Jesus. Alright, there's another guy in here. I don't seem to have a problem avoiding these guys. Okay, I wanna look. I don't wanna look, but... Aw, doll with a rope. Hey, I made it though. Then all of a sudden I'm back in the house. This is like, this is weird. I like the whole can't get your thoughts straight idea though. Oh boy. I am nervous to look at this doll though. I saw that was a normal face and I was expecting it to blink. There don't seem to be like... Oh, what the fuck? No! No, you dolls aren't gonna get me. I don't think I noticed that for a second. I think it was moving for a second before I noticed it. Dolls aren't getting me. Okay, this is probably just gonna be a bedroom. That doll, it was that doll that was like right in front of the table. Okay, I'm gonna hold my sprint for a second just in case I need it. I wanna work through this area as quickly as possible, but at the same time I don't wanna just die a million times. I haven't died, actually. I just realized. I really haven't, like, had a death in a little while that's, like, non-scheduled. Because there's parts where, like, he wakes up and he dies. Every part, like, every section ends with something, like, brutal and disgusting and he dies in some way. But... Seems like the hospital, like, with that sink right there. But still, it looks like the house. That's the weird part. You have overlap from other areas. Better not come alive. Yep, it came alive. Get out of here. You're not getting me. You're not killing me like Chucky does. I'm actually wondering about that now. Just because I said that, there haven't been any, like, there hasn't been a Chucky movie in a long time, and I wonder if, like, they've been reviving all these series, like, the last couple of years, all these movie series have gotten reboots, you know, like, they've rebooted Nightmare on Elm Street, Friday the 13th, there's so many different horror movies, so many non-horror movies that have gotten reboots, for better and worse. A lot of them have actually been for the better, but I wonder if they're gonna reboot, ever reboot the Chucky movies. It's not worth checking that door. This one I'm already gonna be next to. Oh, that was Dolls and Blood. That's what they're gonna do to me if they grab a hold of me. Alright, well, I made it to stairs, so... Oh no, these aren't stairs. Just another room. Bye-bye. Oh, the one that was walking toward me with the broken out face. No. Alright, I have to play... I'm gonna play a happy game. Directly after this, I have to play some game that isn't just, like, depressing in all the ways, because this is, like, too much depression just to soak all in. Get away. They're slow, that's the bright side, but they also did just, like, collapse in on me. They're like, get them, boys, girls, dolls. That one started moving. I'm looking at some of them and thinking, like, okay, that's one that most likely will start moving. That's one that, like, won't start moving. I was wrong about that last one that started moving. I'm wondering with the whole doll thing, like, maybe the dolls will get explained in this ending? I still had the belief that, like, he's gonna come out of the nightmare okay in one of these endings. Like, my belief is hopefully that this is the true ending, but at the same time, I'm kind of having my doubts just based on the direction of the two endings. Oh, there's nowhere to go here. That's odd. So I am supposed to continue left? Oh, I can continue left. It looked like a dead end. Shut up. Shut those eyes up. Don't you blinky blonk at me. Ooh, that's a lot of them. You go all the way down, that way they can't grab me instantly. Go away. These kind of look like the dolls from Toy Story also. Like the ones that Sid played with. Not played with, but that he, like, messed with. That's what this makes me kind of think of. Like the toys are after me. Maybe I am Sid. Maybe that's the ending of the game. You find out that this is all just Toy Story. Creepy rocking horse. This is a dead end. Is that supposed to happen? I kind of was walking towards the doll expecting it to kill me. And I'm just going to take a moment to think about this. It just dragged my intestines out like it was winning a prize. Yeah, I think that was what was supposed to happen. Nothing from that? Oh, okay. I'm not controlling anything. What? Achievement unlocked, Wayward Dreamer. That one confused me the most. So she was... So that one was him as a kid, and... He woke up. I walked in the other room. She was in her bed. I kissed her goodnight, and then he went back to his bed. That one confused me the most. Because I'm kind of thinking that one is actually just his dreams as a child or something. That one's just like his dreams as a child then. That's all I'm getting out of that one. I might have to look that one up, just a better explanation. I'm excited to go look up more about this game now though, because now I actually have the opportunity to look up more and it won't ruin anything, but let's make sure it didn't unlock an extra path. Yep. Okay, so every path is basically fulfilled. There's one path I didn't take, which don't know if you can see my mouse, but it's from the one with the dark hair right here, and it goes to the original middle one. That's the only path I didn't take, but I still completed every area, so I am considering this completed. But I was thinking that there's the possibility that maybe another dream would branch off after I completed all three, but it seems not. But for now, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, if you liked this game, please go down below, let me know in the comments, and I will see you guys in the next video. We'll be right back.